looking for that uppercut or that knee as he was coming in, and he caught Okami coming in. The last two things, I don't know if they're keys as much as they are strengths. Umrah does a really good job of making adjustments in the fight. When things aren't going his way or a certain game plan wasn't unfolding the way that he thought it would, he'll make an adjustment and go to a plan B. This is what I was talking about, both these guys being well-rounded. Umrah, if he's planning on keeping this fight standing and it's not going his way, he'll look for the takedown. He'll win the match there. And the one thing that you know about Umrah is he has grit. This guy has a chin of granite. He doesn't stop. He's got cardio for days. He will fight to his last breath if need be.
With the introductions, here's Tom Lau.
This next match is 300 pounds of middleweight MMA, presented to you by Monster Energy. Unleash the beast. And when the action begins, your referee in charge, Mr. Herb Dean. Introducing first, out of the blue corner, training out of Lone Year's MMA, holding a mixed martial arts record of 19-3 with 17 highlight reel finishes. Representing China, the King Kong Warrior, Fan Ruan. Introducing his opponent out of the red corner. He is a former 2 Division 1 world champion, holding a mixed martial arts record of 29-13 with an incredible 27 finishes. Representing Myanmar, the Burmese Python, Ola
Final instructions, Herb Dean, here at a sold-out First Bank Center in Denver. One championship arrives in the United States for the first time. This much-anticipated card, and this fight, the third of the night. Umrah and Song in the red gloves. Fan Rong in the blue. 3 5-minute rounds, and again, the bout judged as a whole.
Fan Rong's been out since December of 2021. I'm really interested to see the improvements that he's made in his striking. His wrestling is always top level, but I want to see how he's put together his boxing, because Umrah on the feet has just bricks in his gloves, and that right side is so dangerous.
So far, that lead jab and hook that he's put out there seems to give Umrah a little bit of fits, or a problem or a puzzle to solve at least.
Yeah, I'd like to see Umrah start putting out those kicks. He's got a thunderous right side out of that right leg. I'd like to see him start using it, especially start chopping down the legs of Fan Rong, which is going to affect his shot later in the fight. Big right, looping right hand landed by Umrah.
Former 2 Division 1 world champ, Umrah Song, trying to get back on top. Says, even if I don't, man, I'm just going to keep fighting the best, and I'm going to keep beating them. You mentioned his last 8 wins by knockout, and good exchange there between the two in the second minute of round one.
Fan Rong lands a nice little combination with that finishing uppercut.
Left hook there from Umrah.
He's doing a good job with the footwork there. Umrah's in the southpaw stance. Fan Rong is orthodox, and he's winning that front foot battle, getting to the outside. That's what set up that uppercut that you mentioned, Mitch. That lead hook keeps coming over top of the guard of Umrah, giving him trouble.
Body kick from Umrah. A straight left from Umrah. And another. Trying to split the guard of Fan here. Umrah fanning there on a body kick.
Fan Rong did a good job right there with the footwork, managing distance. Umrah came in with that left. Just missed. It was a big commitment by Umrah. It took him off balance. He didn't have to pay the price for it.
Fan Rong's doing a good job of circling to the non-dominant side of Umrah. Stay out of the way of that left side. and lobs back to right. Let's see if Fan Rong starts moving to the other, and he does. Good footwork control from Fan Rong.
Yeah, Ong Law switched it up with a straight right that time. Herb Dean steps in, stops the fight midway round one, and back to action as they trade with a right.
Right, but then he curls it under at the last moment and comes through your guard. Very tricky with that right uppercut, but a beautiful combination right there from Fan Rong to go to the body.
Yeah, dig into the body, Fan, the man from China.
I'm not sure if you guys have noticed or not, but Ong Law has now switched to conventional. He's back to southpaw. But he was in conventional for quite some time. It wasn't just a momentary switch. He had stayed in that stance for a good minute and a half.
Yeah, he's playing almost a time thing, right? Every couple of minutes or a minute or so, he switches the stance. And it's hard to get a read on it, but Fan Rong's doing a good job of controlling his footwork and continually circling to whatever side Fan Rong's, Ong Law is dominant in.
Blood coming from the left eye, streaming down the left side of the face of Fan Rong, who said this would be a 50-50 match. There are no advantages for either fighter in any area. That was Fan's take on this fight going in.
Fan Rong's definitely showing some improved stand-up, Rich.
For sure, and all this is coming down to the footwork. This is new footwork that we haven't seen from him before, the ability to negate that distance. Normally, he would allow his opponent to come in and then kind of negate that with his wrestling, but this time he's managing it with range.
Right hook and a left up top from Ong Law, and Fan returns fire. Minute to go, round one. Again, the bout judged as a whole. Ong Law in the red gloves, Fan Rong in the blue gloves.
That was a nice counter right hand landed by Fan Rong to slide out of the way and then come right back with it.
It's another example, Fan Rong using that footwork. Ong Law committing big to the body shot there, committing big to that last one, and that's what allowed Fan Rong to land that counter.
So here's the deal. Fan Mitch is showing the damage, but he seems to be winning this first round.
Well, he's scoring successfully, and a lot of it's coming off that lead hand. Like you talked about in your keys to victory, the feints, right? Like he's pawing at that lead hand just to get Ong Law and Sam just a little bit of a distraction. Nice little lead uppercut there as Ong Law starts to smile at him and move forward.
Yes, this lead hand is coming in as a straight jab. It's coming in as a little punching uppercut. Oh, he's rocked.
Two huge lefts from Ong Law. Can Fan survive the round? Looks to have his wits about him here in the final 10 seconds.
Ong Law is usually a lot more kick heavy. I'm wondering why he's choosing just to box with Fan Rong.
Uppercut from Ong Law, and there's the bell.
Agree with you on that, and there was a time before in this round where I thought Ong should throw his left kick, and he did, and it landed. Each time he's thrown that left kick, it's landed really well, been effective.
Prime Video is talking sports Monday to Friday live from 8 a.m. to 8 p.m. on Sports Talk. Tune in for new and diverse hosts talking about the biggest sports stories of the day. All sports, all day, only on Prime Video.
Let's take a look at that first round. Here's this right hand that comes right down the middle. Boom. Touches Fan Rong right on the side of the head. It was a beautiful shot landed by Ong Law, and that's what did the damage to that eye, open the cut. But a beautiful, look at that, pull back right hand went right down the middle for Fan Rong.
Yeah, it was that first one, and Ong Law comes in here and lands another one. But most of the time when he's landing combinations, it doesn't come without some sort of counter that he's paying for it himself. Ong Law is making big commitments with his footwork on this, and that's what allowed Fan in that first highlight to slide back and come back with that counter. He's got to figure that out, solve that puzzle, because the lead hand, that hook, is what's giving him the fits.
The bell in round two.
But I like the way Ong Law finished that round, coming forward, throwing heavy shots, showing some confidence of the former champion.
High kick from Ong Law there to open the second. Fan willing to stand toe-to-toe and trade with Ong Law, the former world champ.
Yeah, Ong Law likes the southpaw stance, Rich.
Absolutely, and that last left kick was a nice left hand was a nice left hand that he threw there. Ong followed up with his footwork. You see there, he did it again, and he wasn't available for the punch. Both of them landed right there.
Fan rocked him with the right.
Ong Law works for the wear, right, though. There's the first takedown attempt. Sits Ong Law down.
Fan with a single.
He's got a choke sunk in here.
Yeah, but that's probably, he's kind of going for a
first. He's tapping.
That's all.
What? Ong Law making Fan Rong pay for the shot with a modified guillotine. Gets the tap in the second round, Ridge.
Got himself a guillotine using his body to create the angle.
kind of came out of nowhere. You felt like Van had the advantage, but...
Well, it did come out of nowhere. Even Mitch at that point was like, yeah, but because he doesn't normally typically quite have the angle. The Van wrongly crowded himself. Umbaugh was able to keep the body in tight, creating that pressure in the neck.
Didn't even have the hooks, didn't even lock the legs in. Just wrapped up the choke. Kind of reminded everybody why his nickname is the Burmese Python.
But the choke finished once they actually fell to the side, and that's what gave him the ability to hold on to the legs.
Were you surprised by that tap? It sounded like...
Yeah, I was 100% surprised. Ung La has got a squeeze on him to get that sunk in so deep with the improper position. Van Rong looked like he was going to be okay, but immediately started tapping. What a finish.
I just got to say, Mitch, I wasn't surprised. They called the Burmese Python for a reason.
Wow. Wow. See, I set you up. That's my fault, Mitch Chilson.
He threw me the softball.
Circle side with the Dragon, Mitch Chilson, former ONE fighter, and then Hall of Famer, Rich Ace Franklin, ONE Fight Night 10. And for the particulars, back inside the ONE Circle for Dom Lau.
Ladies and gentlemen, your referee, Mr. Herb Dean, has called a stop to this contest after 48 seconds in the second round for your winner by way of guillotine, Ung La Ung Sa!
Ung La's 30th career win, 28 by finish. It's a second round submission victory. And after 8 straight wins by knockout, he switches it up to complete this win over Van Rong of China.
You know, I mentioned this before about Ung La. This is what I'm talking about. He doesn't get rattled in the cage by anything, and that circle is never rattled. He fights like a true veteran and just stays calm no matter what the situation.
Mitch standing by with the Burmese Python.
Ung La, you just asked me if that was entertaining. Denver, Colorado, was that entertaining? Now, it didn't look like you had the proper position, but once you got that choke in, he was only in there for moments before you got the finish. Was that tight?
It was tight. Hey, first and foremost, I want to thank God, Jesus Christ, my Lord and Savior. I'm an immigrant from Myanmar. American dream is still alive and well. God bless America. Pray for Myanmar. I want to thank my team, Kill Cliff FC, Henry Hoof, Greg Jones, Duco, thank you guys. Dr. Peacock, thank you. Coach Stroud, Nick Lance, all the coaches there, Sean Soriano, thank you guys so much for equipping me with a weapon to do what I do in the case. Thank you guys.
You've surrounded yourself with an incredible team. The work is definitely the proof of that. Now, I got to ask, you called yourself the gatekeeper of the division, but you keep knocking down everybody that comes to the gate. So what's next for Ung La and Song?
I want to finish everybody as a gatekeeper until Chatri, ONE Championship, gives me that title shot. And I don't care. I just want to stay active. I just want to fight.
I just want to watch you fight. Denver, Colorado, make some noise for your winner, Ung La Ung Song.
In the country of Myanmar, that man, Ung La Ung Song, is the country's biggest sports star. There is a statue of him. Gets mobbed by fans everywhere he goes.
Yeah, you know, Ung La, a fan came out in the beginning of this match, and he was having issues with that lead hand of Fan Rong trying to find the range that he needed. Fan Rong was able to land some of these other shots, the uppercut, the right cross there, being able to slide in and out with the footwalk. But eventually, Ung La was able to find him, cut him open with a right hand of his own. And this was the beginning of the end. Ung La made some adjustments in this match, being able to solve that puzzle. But ultimately, when they finally came out in that second round, this is where the change began to occur. Both of these guys landed a lead hook right there and wobbled Ung La, but I think that was more about him being off balance. He let Van Rong just take the shot, immediately went to this modified guillotine with the choke on the back of the neck right there. Van Rong couldn't go anywhere because the whole body was trapped in. He grabbed the leg right there as they were falling to the side, didn't quite get there, but it was sunk. Van Rong, you could watch him after the match. He even